Good evening, I'm Liz Bishop.
And I'm Greg Floyd. Westbound lanes of I-90 near the Patroon Island Bridge, they are back open right now. That after a bizarre chain of events sends one man to the hospital.
Yeah, it happened around 9:30 this morning. Investigators say Daniel Granger was driving over the bridge toward Albany when he had a car problem.
It's what happens next that has the Capital Region talking tonight. Kimberly Howard, live near the Patroon Island Bridge. And Kimberly, I know this is very odd. Different versions depending on who you ask as to what happened here.
Yeah, that's right, Greg and Liz. First responders say a witness, a construction worker who was working in this area, told them that he saw a man either fall or jump 50 feet off of this bridge, only to survive and then be hit by a tractor trailer after climbing back up. But state police, after spending hours out here with an accident reconstruction team, say that's not what happened.
It's tragic. Freak things happen.
And what happened to a driver crossing the Patroon Island Bridge during the morning rush differs depending on who you ask. The Albany Fire Department responded, and when they did, they say it appeared a man hit the guardrail. They have gotten out to look at the damage, but then quickly realized he would get hit if he didn't get out of the way. That's when they say he hopped the guardrail and either jumped or fell 50 feet off the bridge and into a blanket of snow.
It was a construction worker that had seen this and got in his truck and drove around to the other side of the bridge where they're working on the repairs there. And by the time he got there, he looked up, didn't find the person, and looked up, he was climbing up the hill back onto the highway.
First responders said the man was then hit by a tractor trailer doing about 25 miles an hour.
I heard that he had some possible breaks in the arm injury, some lacerations, road rash on his back, possible internal injuries.
But still conscious when paramedics rushed him to Albany Medical Center.
Conscious, I'm talking, yeah.
After hours of investigating, state police determined that at no point did a man fall or jump off the bridge. Police say instead, 32-year-old Daniel Granger got a flat tire and then for some reason crossed two lanes of traffic before being struck by a tractor trailer and thrown 50 feet. As far as the discrepancy in the two stories, first responders say they only know what they were told when they first got on the scene, and state police are still investigating. And we also reached out to the DOT to speak with that construction worker about what he saw, but we were told he didn't want to be interviewed. Meanwhile, Granger is still in the hospital at last check in stable condition, but with injuries to both his head and chest. No charges have been filed. Live in Albany, Kimberly Howard, CBS 6 News.
All right, Kimberly, thank you. And CBS 6 tracking developing news out of the Bethlehem School District right now. It says a student at Ellesmere Elementary School has a case of whooping cough. It's a highly contagious respiratory infection, and it can spread through sneezing or coughing. The student with the infection is being treated, and those who have come in contact have been identified and treated as well. Whooping cough begins with cold-like symptoms, and then a persistent cough worsens after a few weeks. The district has all this information on its website. And CBS 6 is continuing to follow this developing story. We'll certainly bring you any more information as soon as it becomes available.